Hello guys, welcome to the Russian channel, and today's lesson is about regular plurals of nouns. Which in Russian would be множественное число существительных. In case you haven't watched the video about regular plurals, see it in the description, and then return to this one. The irregular forms can be divided according to the gender, and most of the irregular forms belong to the masculine. And the first group would be the consonants and to which A or Ya sounds are added. So let's see the examples. Адрес becomes адреса. Глаз would be глаза. Учитель becomes учителя. And you see the Ya sound is added to the soft letter, which in this case is Л. Доктор becomes доктора. And профессор would be профессора. So the next group's endings is soft sign plus Я sound. So to the брат, we add these letters and we have братья in the plural forms. Сын becomes сыновья. And you see there is also OF letters are added as well. Лист becomes листья. Друг, друзья. And again, the sound is changed. From Г it becomes З. Стул becomes стулья in the plural forms. So, the last group in the masculine gender is the nouns which end in АНИН or ЯНИН. So, to make a plural form, you just need to remove ин and add НИ. Let's see the examples. Англичанин becomes англичане in the plural form. Гражданин would be граждане. Датчанин would be датчане. Христианин becomes христиане in the plural. Мусульманин becomes мусульмане. That's easy, I guess, if you learn it. And now let's turn to the feminine and neuter gender nouns. They are much less frequent than the masculine gender irregular forms. Дочь becomes дочери, дочери. And you just add ери. Мать becomes матери. Деревья would be in the plural form деревья. Время, which is neuter as well, becomes времена. Имя would be имена. So be careful with the stress. You see it changes when the nouns become plural. Ухо becomes уши. You see the letter has changed. Яблоко, яблоки. And now, at last, there are some neuter nouns which never change. Which is great, I guess. Even when you will learn the cases, they will never change. Just remember that. Keep it in your mind. Метро. Кофе. Радио. Кафе. Виски, кенгуру, такси, пианино. As you have noticed, maybe not, but all these words are borrowed from other languages. And now here is a bonus for today's lesson, and it is a construction which you can use when you want to say that you have something. So in Russian, I have something would be у меня есть. And this sentence you can use with inanimated objects and with different people. So let's see examples. For example, у меня есть машина. I have a car. Or у нас есть телефоны. I have phones. У меня есть сестра и брат. I have a sister and a brother. У нас есть друзья. We have friends. Now let's see the you forms. You have. У тебя есть. У вас есть. The difference is between у тебя and у вас is that у вас is more polite if you're referring to the one person or you or when you address to several people in the group. Let's read the dialogues. Паша, у тебя есть карандаш? Do you have a pencil? Да, держи. Yeah, take it. У вас есть брат? Да. Его зовут Игорь. Он студент. And at last, the last three forms. She has. У нее есть. I hope you remember the words which we had in previous lessons. So, do you remember it? Это яблоко. У нее есть яблоко. У нее есть... Do you remember it? У нее есть книга. Yeah. He has. У него есть. У него есть словарь. У него есть дом. And at last, у них есть телефон. У них есть компьютер. That's easy. So, just practice it with other nouns which we have learned. Thank you for today's lesson and I hope you enjoyed it. Follow us in our social media. Bye-bye, see you.